In the United States, drinking water systems are what we call centralized, meaning you bring the water in to one big plant, you treat it in one place, and then you distribute it out to the community. It has really helped develop our economy by having safe and high quality water in this country, but these systems are pretty inflexible. If you have a hurricane come through and your system goes down, it can take weeks to put that back online. Whereas a decentralized system, which is at a neighborhood scale or a household scale, you can get them back online faster. A combination of decentralized and centralized systems together, coupled with smart technologies, if you will, I think is a good solution for the United States.
Yeah, I mean, it changes color. The water changes color.
So you dipped it more than once?
The next generation of water engineers will need a knowledge set they can't get in today's textbooks. They will need to be able to understand and innovate more sustainable and specialized systems in the U.S. and developing countries. Nancy Love, a professor of civil and environmental engineering at the University of Michigan, is partnering with Geremu Sahilu, assistant professor of civil and environmental engineering at Addis Ababa Institute of Technology in Ethiopia. Together, they are developing a curriculum to train students in both countries how to design decentralized water systems.
The ultimate goal is to get that curriculum online and make it open access. In Addis Ababa, their centralized wastewater plant serves less than 10% of the population of the city. Coming up with solutions that handle the sewage and septage at the neighborhood scale and does it well is really what a decentralized technology would do.
The world is a village now. Scientific knowledge doesn't have a border, but it should expand through collaboration. We should learn from the problems here in order to change the world.
The work in Ethiopia and the way in which we're doing this work is really designed to empower the Ethiopians, to partner with them in ways that both build their curriculum and build their graduate research capacity so that these solutions are their solutions. I see them as the face of it, and we are the partner in that process, kind of driven by the needs that they have, and that's really what the class is about. That's what the research projects I work there are about. It's really capacity building, plain and simple.